Well, hello then. Here we are, autumn colour coming in the woods now, and as you can see behind me here, and can't believe these seasons come around so fast, can you? You know that there's something horribly sick and horrid that's going on with that which names the name of Jesus. We talk about it quite a lot, of course, for all of us who know him. And I'm on something of a mission, if you like, to find out what this is all about. Why are we like this? What's going on here? And I think what Satan has done over time, he has built this monstrous church thing that is so ubiquitous, it is so absolutely blinding, it is woven into the fabric of every society on the planet, bar out and out pagan ones, that actually we can't see the truth. And this has a blinding effect on our God, our God's people, all of us, if we're not careful. Now, why are we being blinded? Should be the question for us all. Let's all take an interest in this, and let's be intelligent, shall we? Let's stop being silly, because this is not a game. Think about this. If the world approves of something, then it's Satan's approval, isn't it? If the world is happy for something to exist, then it isn't of God, is it? Jesus said to his people, our people of the past, in the days when he walked in the flesh in this world, he said quite simply, you'll be hated of all men for my namesake, that you'll be the offscouring of the world. And that was true initially, until Satan, around about 300 AD, started to build church, society based upon church, and his empire painted with Christian words and names. The woman you see riding the beast to Revelation 17, the Roman Catholic cult, but now, after a good, yeah, further, what, 1700 years, we see every flavour of wretched church you can imagine, just so that Satan can keep his finger on things and keep under control. Church is emphatically not of God. In the UK, the British government gives churches tax-exempt status, and I'm sure that that's what happens in your country too, doesn't it? They are not required to produce, you know, accounts and all this kind of stuff, and pay taxes to the exchequer in the same way a company would. Now that's interesting, isn't it? The world approves of church. The world gives it special tax status. The world is happy for it to be there. Everywhere you've got these tax-exempt organizations approved of the world. But this is far wider and deeper than we're thinking about. Look, if Satan's people, the body of Satan, the world, is happy with church, then the alarm bells should be ringing for all of us, shouldn't they? Think about it. In fact, in British society, church is so woven into the fabric of life that they teach in schools Christianity. And indeed, something struck me the other day. It's church that crowns the British monarchy. And if church is crowning the monarchy, the alarm bells should be ringing big time. Because you see, if we see Revelation 18, church, Babylon the Great, wiped out by the Lord, That means British society gets wiped out too, doesn't it? This is serious stuff. And when the crown is placed on the head of a British monarch, it's Antichrist that's crowning the monarch. They call it Christian, and of course, you know, even JWs want to be called Christian today. But nevertheless, it's nothing to do with God whatsoever. Oh, yes, he allowed it, and ultimately he's responsible. But who's crowning the monarch? Is this why we've had, a little while ago, Ratty from the Vatty, the Antichrist in the UK, visiting a state visit? And this why Her Majesty the Queen goes to Rome to see, or has been about 2 or 3 years ago, to see Frankie in the Frock, the cursed Antichrist? You see, this is all interlinked, and this isn't just the UK, this is all over Europe. The world approves of church. The only thing it doesn't approve of is disciples. Now, you and I speak the truth of God. We go out there and this does offend people. And they've got this alternative now. They're saying, why don't you go to church? Why don't you be like other Christians? Why don't you, you know, just go to church and do your church stuff? And I've had an unsaved person years ago, a member of the family, who said to me, why don't you go to church? You've got to go to church. Why are Satan's people endorsing church? Why does Satan's people endorse the monarchy, crowned with a Christian crown? We know Satan's world headquarters is Rome. Beyond question, used to be Pergamos, called Bergamot today, in northwest Turkey, but around about 2nd century, when Bergamot, as it is today, got trashed, Satan moved his world headquarters to Rome and built the monster that you see, church, the grey monster. If these people who actually run and control things behind the scenes, like the bankers, are all Catholics, you know, the Jews are in with them, of course, as well, and the Jews are hostile to God, absolutely hostile. And if the world endorses church, then we'd better run for our lives and get well away from church, hadn't we? It's nothing to do with discipleship. The grey monster, church, is just off the radar as far as we're concerned. You can't walk with the Lord and walk with that. And the endorsement of the world, which is patently obvious, shows it, surely. QED. Let's dump church, shall we? If it's associated with Frankie's mob in Rome, and the world approves of it, it's downright satanic. The enemies of God, the unsaved, the vast bulk of humanity, they all endorse it. They support it, don't they? When Her Majesty the Queen dies, and she's not a young woman now by any means, when she dies, no doubt there'll be a huge amount of national mourning and grief, because she's held in very high regard. But then when there's another crowning of the next monarch, if the politicians don't try and make their move then and destroy the British monarchy and wipe out church, maybe that's the point at which it all falls apart, a la Revelation 18, I don't know. But nevertheless, it's going to be Satan who's crowning the next monarch. It's nothing to do with us. We're saved out of the world. These people are quite happy to have Satan's work in the form of church amongst them, aren't they? And if they're happy with that, that testifies to us that is not a God and nothing to do with us, is it? These things are so big, and everywhere it's all in such a mess. I think we all better sit up and take notice, and let's heave overboard the world whether it's painted in Christian words and names or not. Let us ditch it all. Let us forget nationalism. Let us move on. Because if Satan is crowning the British monarch, which is what he does, then I'm afraid the British head of state is utterly, utterly wrong and enemy of God. Not that we're hostile to them, we're not. Mostly the Queen has my respect. But we don't need to associate with it, do we?